fasting is the new fad, and if you check numerous forums where people talk about their fasting experience, you'll find it has helped a lot of people lose weight. You'll see people talking about how they tried all kinds of diets, the low carb, the keto diet, low fat, reduced sugar, all kinds. But for some folks, none of those worked for them. Then they fasted, and the weight came off. On top of that, they talk about mental clarity, feeling light on their feet, more agile. You can watch David Sinclair, a professor in the Department of Genetics at Harvard Medical School, telling people they should skip meals, something in the past that was seen as an unhealthy way to live. So what actually happens when you fast, either doing the short intermittent fasts or the grueling 5-day fasts? Let's find out. Harvard University is where we decided to go to find out about intermittent fasting, only because we believe we can trust the school's research over some other more dubious health guru websites. Scientists at Harvard, including David Sinclair, who we just mentioned, have done all kinds of tests on rats to see what makes them healthier or unhealthier. When it comes to fasting, the rats came out looking pretty good. The results were often the same with any of the rats on a fast. It would lose weight, and its blood pressure, cholesterol, and blood sugars would often improve. The U.S. National Institutes of Health agreed that when rats fasted, there were health benefits, including a more efficient energy metabolism. That's rats, though, not humans. So what scientists then had to find out is, would humans get the same benefits? Should we give up 3 square meals a day or lots of small meals and just deprive ourselves of food now and again? Let's have a look at what happens to the body when we fast. The experts tell us that when we don't feed ourselves for somewhere between 12 and 16 hours, our glycogen stores in our liver become depleted. The body then switches from using sugar as a source of energy to using fat. If you did a lot of exercise, this can also happen. This metabolic state that happens during this time we call ketosis, and this brings about changes in the body. Most of us don't actually reach this state because we've grown up being told to eat when we're hungry, don't go to school on an empty stomach, or we just put sugar in that morning coffee at the office. Fasting means trying to avoid calorie intake, although there are some that say that a few calories might still keep your body in the fasting state. That's debatable, as some say only have water or tea. As we said, some leading researchers around the world did lots of tests on rats, allowing some to eat what they wanted and others were only given food now and again. This is the conclusion we found in one paper that was published by the National Institutes of Aging. Emerging evidence suggests that intermittent dietary energy restriction might improve overall health and reduce risk factors for diabetes and cardiovascular disease in humans. Our new findings in laboratory animals provide evidence that similar intermittent eating patterns can enhance the beneficial effects of aerobic exercise on endurance performance. You can read a lot of books on why our obesity crisis happened, and the long and short of it is many people are too sedentary, or just eat way too much and way too much sugary processed food. It won't surprise you that the book The Obesity Code tells people they shouldn't constantly be snacking and they should try and eat healthy foods, more veggies, fruits, healthy proteins, and less refined grains, processed foods, and sugar. It's no surprise that some of the fattest countries in the world have a snacking culture and a fast food culture. Still, some people do eat quite well and can't seem to lose weight. It's as if the body has a certain calibration and wants to stay at a particular weight. That's where fasting has helped people. It's worked where diets have failed. You see, there's some evidence that even when we restrict our bodies of calories, the body thinks, "Oh God, I'm starving!" And so it slows down and takes what it can from the few calories you put in. Even if you're a big person, if you reduce calories, you might not lose weight because your body goes into survival mode. It slows down its metabolism. If you watch enough Joe Rogan, you'll know that this is an ongoing argument. But what most people do agree on is that fasting seems to work for most people. But if you look at human studies, which had some people on a plant-based healthy diet and some others doing one-day fasts, the results weren't much different. Some people lost weight, others weren't affected much at all. Then again, there's lots of evidence out there from people who actually tried fasting, and the results for most people were positive. But we'll get around to that later. Researchers from the University of Alabama were interested to see if fasting might help people with pre-diabetes, meaning that they were on their way to getting full-blown diabetes. It's well known that if you eat a ton of food before you sleep, it can increase your chances of getting diabetes. We don't need to tell you that if you are very obese because your fingers are hardly ever doing anything other than putting chips, cookies, and all kinds of processed junk into your mouth, you're at risk of getting diabetes. The proof is in the pudding, and America has a big pie of evidence. In 2018, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention told us that 1 in 7 Americans has diabetes. And while lifestyle is not to blame for around 5% of the cases, the vast majority of the remaining 95% have diabetes because of a poor diet and resulting obesity. So can fasting help? Well, in one study, the researchers put pre-diabetics on a plan called early time-restricted feeding. This meant some participants could only eat from 7 a.m. until 3 p.m. and nothing else after or before. The other group could eat between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m., a kind of normal time frame for most people. Both groups actually didn't gain weight or lose weight, but those in the 7-3 time frame showed a drop in insulin levels. They also showed a lower blood pressure, and another important factor was they just got used to it and showed a decrease in appetite. There's no doubt that this kind of intermittent fasting has worked for a lot of people, but most researchers do say that if you do it, also try to have a healthy diet and a healthy lifestyle. Dieting may also help, but the fact is some people just find it easier to skip meals. Sometimes it's hard to find healthy food, and sometimes it takes too much time to cook. So fasting is a good option if you want to try and lose weight without much planning or effort. What about fasting not just for a certain part of the day, but missing an entire day's foods? The American Journal of Clinical Nutrition published a study from independent researchers who took a bunch of participants and put them on this one-day-a-week fast for 5 weeks. Its conclusion was that indeed, people lost weight, but they were also hungry during that fasting day. It said perhaps adding one healthy meal in a fasting day would be better. That's why you'll hear a lot about 16-hour fasts, 18-hour fasts, 20-hour fasts. Maybe start with the 16-hour fast and build up to 24 hours. All over the web, there is scientific and anecdotal evidence that fasting can help reduce a person's weight and also help people with type 2 diabetes. Some evidence also points to fasting increasing something called the BDNF protein in the brain, which is why some people claim they have enhanced mental clarity when fasting. Others say that giving the body a break from food can help reduce pain and inflammation, and also help repair cells. Some studies have concluded that chronic pain can be eased if fasting is done in tandem with a vegetarian diet. While there is some quite strong evidence that tells us that fasting might help with other chronic degenerative and inflammatory diseases, we found one paper in which scientists wrote that fasting might help regenerate stem cells, and so could have a positive effect on cancer patients. Studies on animals show that fasting might even reduce the chances of getting Alzheimer's disease or heart problems. But so far, these studies have been done on animals, so right now we should say it's only a possibility it could do the same for humans. We should say, however, that doctors don't recommend pregnant women fast, nor malnourished people, nor people with a history of eating disorders, children, or women who are breastfeeding. Basically, it's best to do it when you're an adult and you feel like you need to lose some weight or lower your blood sugar. During your fasts, drink lots of liquids, mainly water or tea or coffee with no sugar or milk. You can also work out, and don't worry, it's not dangerous to do that according to the health experts. Some people online say they feel great exercising on their fasts, but others have said they felt weak or got a headache. If you do it, take it easy and see how you feel. Just head to any forum and see what people are saying about intermittent fasting, and indeed you'll find scores of people saying that they lost weight, felt more mentally alert, while after fasting they just didn't need as much food as before. As one doctor said online too, his clients found fasting a lot easier to do than following a strict diet plan. Looking at forums, you'll find lots of people saying things like this: "Yes, intermittent fasting is very helpful. I've lost 30 pounds, went from 20%+ body fat to 8% so far just from this March. I've been doing it every day since." There seems little doubt that many people lose weight when doing these fasts, even just 16-hour fasts. Most people will eat their evening meal early, around 5, and then get through most of the morning without food. While a lot more research needs to be done concerning all the health benefits, just reading what people say about their fasts online lets you know that fasting does work for most people if they want to lose weight, while many people enjoy how they feel during the fasts. Have you tried fasting? How was it for you? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, "I did 30 push-ups for 30 days and this is what happened." Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!